everyone, this is Rani from the People's Daily. Have you ever wondered where young foreigners chill out and relax in China? Well now, we are heading to Chaoyang Park in the Chaoyang district of Beijing today.
It was a teenage wedding and the old folks wished them well. You could see that Pierre did truly love the mademoiselle. And now the young monsieur and madame have rung the chapel bell. C'est la vie, say the old folks, it goes to show you never can tell.
Aside from the locals enjoying camping and sunbathing, the grass at Chaoyang Park offers stunning scenery. It's a fantastic spot where foreigners worldwide gather to practice yoga. Let's take a look.
In this green meadow, I saw many foreigners living in China getting close to nature, releasing stress, and experiencing the 20-minute park effect in a corner of the city. They are traveling, playing, living, and working in China, enjoying the numerous relaxation options and the beautiful environment.
Many foreigners participate in special yoga activities designed to relax both body and mind. As we gaze up at the night sky, illuminated by a full moon twinkling stars, a special yoga session unfolds, creating a space where everyone can breathe in harmony with the city.
Hello, my name is Carla, and she is Gary, my daughter.
Hi, I'm Holly.
Hi, I'm Catalina.
Jack Allen.
My name is Yun Su Song.
How's the Laosher?
Okay, and where are you from?
I'm originally from Colorado in the US.
Venezuela.
I'm from the UK.
And I'm from South Korea.
I'm from Ireland.
I'm from the United States.
How long have you been in China?
Long time. 9 years, about.
Almost 10 years.
Wow. I've been in China for 7 years.
I've been here for just under 2 years.
I was here for a year. I came to China for the first time in 2007.
Why do you practice yoga?
I practiced yoga for a while, but seriously, since 4 years ago.
3 years? Yeah.
So since you are in the UK?
Yeah, since I was in the UK and carried on whilst I was in China.
My students and our community, they just love to get together and have these big celebrations. It's the full moon and it just feels so good and like healthy to be in community and practicing together, and it's really to just have fun.
What have you gained from the yoga practice?
It's good exercise. We made lots of friends. Like, there's a new friend. There's a new friend. It's a good community and it's a great hobby. It's healthy and it's fun. Yeah.
For me, I think it's the part of always thinking about that yoga is like more like a work-in instead of a workout for me. So thinking about how it helps me with my emotional, dealing with my emotions, also with a bit of how do I also go out into the world and help others. So like whatever is happening on the mat, you can then take that with you into your real life and support the community around you.
An opportunity to relax a little bit, to de-stress from work and from study, and becoming more in touch with my body, my breath, and my mind.
Yeah, it's for me to develop my flexibility, I guess, and combine that with strength, and to just be aware of my and breath and take things more slowly.
Yoga helped me a lot with to be more patient in my regular life, in my motherhood life,
yeah.
To have more strength. Also, it's for the health, right?
Yeah.
Have more strength, more healthy, to be stronger.
Yeah.
To be able to take my daughter, to climb with my daughter, to run with her, so in the physical part.
Yeah.
So in the mental part also helps a lot to be more patient, to be in peace, to stay with calm, and be more resilient.
yoga has given me everything because the world is like often quite crazy, yeah. You know, like even right in this moment, it's kind of a crazy moment. But I think that the yoga practice has taught me that I can always stay connected to this like peaceful space inside and just let the world be crazy on the outside. And I can stay strong and move through it all with ease. And then that helps others kind of feel that sense of calmness. So I really strongly believe in bringing both local Beijingers and the expat international community together.
Yeah.
I think, you know, the world is so divided oftentimes. And so to have the space to just like breathe together and hold hands and to share like love and quality experience in Beijing, again, with expats and local Beijings together. It's just bridging cultures and bridging gaps in a really like peaceful, loving way. I think it's very, very important.
Do you like the lifestyle here in China?
Yes.
Why?
Really easy to like get stuff. Like, I don't know how to explain, but big country, a lot of stuff.
Like what? You mean a lot of snack,
a lot of malls, a lot of places, a lot of people, and it's really fun.
You really enjoy the lifestyle in China, in Beijing, because we live in Beijing. So we enjoy a stay here. We enjoy the culture, we enjoy the people.
It's been very good fun so far. Like I started studying and then carried on working here. So yeah, really enjoying my time in China so far.
Yeah, it's been really fun for me as well. When I graduated, I really wanted to continue working here. So it's been fun. I'm always up to like learn and experience the country more in different settings.
我喜欢中国，因为这个他们的temple都特别好，然后我就觉得特别酷，然后特别特别大，这中国。你去过最远的地方是哪里？ 黄山，我爬上去了我三岁时候。
Definitely, I'm here 10 years. I'm Chinese practically now, right? I've lived here longer than the kids I teach, right? Because they're 3 years old.
Yeah, are you enjoying it?
Yes, I love living in Beijing and I probably will stay a long more time as well.
It's pretty easy to live here. Actually, when you leave China and you're traveling, sometimes I'm like, oh, I miss the conveniences of China sometimes. So yeah, wonderful place to live.
Honestly, we love living here. I mean, we hope to stay and raise our family here as long as we can. It actually feels weird when I go home. Like Beijing, it's really weird to honestly feel that way, that like Beijing, like 我也是北京人，我真的我的感觉是, I'm like, I am a part of Beijing and Beijing is a part of me, and my children feel that way. Like they feel like they are Beijingers, been born here, we're raising our family here. We think it's such a safe place. It's so beautiful. The people are so friendly. We love it. That's why we're still here.
What's the biggest convenience you've encountered here?
Taobao.
Pretty much you can use your phone for anything. I don't have to worry about taking my a purse with wallets and money. Everything's on the phone, so it's very convenient to do anything. You can get an easy DD ride wherever you want in the city. You can use it for the subway. You can use it for ordering food, ordering anything online. Again, convenience, it's really great.
It's very easy to get fat here. Too convenient. Yeah. Where I live, you can't get takeaway to your house. You have to drive and pick it up, go a long time. Here, it's boop, 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 Beitan. Too easy.
Yeah, very convenient to live in China. We've enjoyed it a lot. The biggest convenience, public transportation, I think. It's very quick and very speedy and very efficient.
For me, the biggest convenience is definitely Meituan and Taobao, like the Waimai. It's amazing. It's very convenient.
The best convenience is there's a lot of people. Uh-huh. A lot of people. And there's a lot of places to buy food. Like, next door, there's already a shop. Like, so close.
Yeah, and where are you living?
Chaoyang
District. Yeah, do you think it is convenient?
Yes.
You know, we bike everywhere. We either bike or we walk or we take DDs. I mean, it's just convenient transportation. I love going to the vegetable markets. So I get to cook like really fresh food every day. Like my favorite place to go is the vegetable market. And yeah, it's not like that at home. So I really love that here.
Where have you gone in China?
Shanghai, around. Where are we going?
I've been to Ningxia. Is that what it's called? The wine country in the west part of China. And also Zhangjiajie. Is that how you say it? The Avatar Mountains.
What will you recommend to your foreign friends if they travel to China?
Probably to go to Yunnan. To see all of the different places in the southwest of China. The nature is really fantastic there.
I would recommend in Beijing. I really love like the Summer Palace and Yuanmingyuan, so I definitely recommend those for autumn. Maybe the Beida campus if you can go. And also, yeah, just because China has so many different climates and regions, I just want people to go where they like. If they want to see the mountains, they can go to Guilin. If they want to see the desert, they can go to Dunhuang. So I really suggest people like go where it interests them. Yeah.
From convenient mobile payments to ease of transportation, shopping, housing, and medical care, foreign friends told me about the little details of their lives in China. They said they had found a sense of home in Beijing, which made them feel they could settle down here.
As China opens its doors wider to the world, we are thrilled to see more and more foreign friends exploring, working, and settling in this vibrant country. The Chinese government has made significant strides to optimize measures for foreigners, making it easier for them to travel and live here. Insights from foreign friends are invaluable. We appreciate them sharing their experiences and thoughts on life in China.